swag. Back in
this bitch, now these... Hey, you already know who it is, man. It's your boy Layback. Back in here with another reaction, another review, another episode. Make sure y'all hit that subscribe button. Hey! Anyway, look, back in here, man. Episode of Everyday Struggle. And I think they doing pretty well this week. I think they doing pretty well. So today they got Safari on the show. Love & Hip Hop star, ex to Nicki Minaj. You know, beef with Meek Mill guy. Got jumped by Meek Mill. That guy's up in the building. So today, DJ Academics, Joe Budden, and Nadeska interview this guy. And I gotta say, it was hell of an entertaining, man. First of all, the dude was fly as a motherfucker. He stepped in there with the mink on, or the fox. First it was a fox. Then he switched over. I think it was another fox or a mink, but whatever. It was ice cold, though. Ice cold. So in mid interview, he just switched. Somebody just comes in. The dude named Messiah comes in and just switches his mink. And Joe Budden is floored. He like, oh my God, that was so cool. But anyway, yeah. So they started talking, right? And they talk about the slut walk with Emma Rose. And, you know, 21 Savage was out there. And everybody beating up 21 Savage. Well, a lot of people beating up on 21. About, you know, how he out there being googly-eyed with his girl, blah, blah, blah. Look, man. I respect what he doing. He with his woman. He's supporting her. What else he supposed to do? Is he supposed to be a gangster with her? You know what I'm saying? So Amber Rose came out on social media and was defending him. And I respect that. But they call him Forever 21, though. Yo, that's crazy. That's crazy. Forever 21. Anyway, man, shout out to 21. Keep doing your thing, bro. Keep holding down, you know what I'm saying, your girl. Amber, keep holding your dude down. And just keep living life, man. Who cares about what these people say about you? You know what I'm saying? So check this out. Do you believe Safari's story about the whole Meek Mill situation, about how he got jumped and stuff? Because when he was talking about it, Joe and them had asked him about it. It was kind of fishy, man. You could kind of tell, like, maybe it was some things he was leaving out or some things that he didn't want to say. Or he was fabricating some things, man. So y'all let me know in the comments. Like, do y'all think when he told his story about the whole Meek Mill situation out in L.A., do you think he was 100% genuine with it or not? But he sound a little shaky to me. He sound a little shaky. He sound like, so it was a couple things he left out or a couple things, you could see it in his face a little bit. You could see it in his face. He wasn't, you know, all the way 100 with certain things. But hey, I wasn't there. So none of us was there. But at the same time, we could still give our opinion on it. What do y'all think? Do y'all think he was being 100% honest? But look, 31 minutes and 37 seconds into the interview. If you go to that on Everyday Struggle, 31 minutes and 37 seconds, you're going to see Academics throw on his Jamaican accent. Yo. When he threw on his Jamaican accent, that shit was hella funny. Because, you know, Safari was questioning him like, bro, where are you from in Jamaica? Da, 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 da. So he threw it on right quick. And then even Safari was like, man, he threw it back at him. He was like, yo, even how you had just spoke in, you know, that Jamaican type of accent, I could tell that you really from there. You know, I could tell how clear and how precise you sound that you was raised there. So they got into the whole Nicki thing. You know, how much did he write for Nicki? What songs did he write for Nicki? Did he write a verse? Did he write a hook? Did he write four songs? And Academics kept pressing him. He kept pressing him, kept pressing him. And Joe Budden was like, look, let's just go ahead and cut it short. It's paperwork that he signed that he can't really detail about what he actually did for Nicki. Safari dapped him up, was like, smart man. So y'all thinking he not speaking on certain things because he not wanting to put the information out there. But he can't speak on these things. When you sign this paperwork saying that, you know, we do this, we do that, you can't speak on it. This confidential information, you can't release it. It's going to be ramifications behind it. So that's why we've never heard him throughout the history say what he has actually done for Nicki. Except he did say the last album that she did, he worked on it all the way up to the last month that it was released. So that right there should be self-explanatory. He worked on a full project until. And he also said he got executive producer credits. Joe Budden broke that down and said, yo, when you get executive producer credits, that means you pretty much worked on the fucking whole thing. You had something to do with picking the beat, writing the song, arranging the song, all that shit. So based on that information, you can kind of see that he did play a big role in it. But based on the confidentiality, he can't say anything about it. But look, man, all in all, this was a very, very, very entertaining show. Very entertaining show. It was a lot of moments in there where it made me laugh. You know, Academics and Safari going back and forth. And even Joe Budden, you know, saying this new show he was going to be old, was going to be trash, was hella funny. So look, man, if y'all haven't checked out that show, this episode in particular, make sure y'all check it out under the Complex YouTube channel. And look, make sure you subscribe to your boy Laid Back. I told you I'm coming in with these reviews for y'all, man. I'm not bullshitting. So look, shout out to everybody that subscribed. Shout out to my supporters out there. I see you. And it's your boy Laid Back, man. Until the next episode, man. We out. Yeah.